The second volume of the Hindi translation, Sri Ram Krishna Bachanamrit, 297-6, and under chapter 31 of the chronologically presented English rendering, the Gospel of Sri Ramakrishna. Let us recapitulate the salient points discussed in our last Sunday class, where Sri Ramakrishna has pointed out the reason for our inability to become successful in life, to reach the goal of life. We all know Sri Ramakrishna has repeatedly said the goal of life, the goal of human life is to realize God. He has not said the goal of life, it's the goal of human life. मनुष्य जीवन उद्देश्य ईश्वर लाभ, ईश्वर दर्शन ही मनुष्य जीवन के उद्देश्य है. दिस स्टेटमेंट शुड बी ऑलवेज रिमेंबर्ड इन द माइंड दैट दिस इज द गोल ओरिएंटेशन इज मोस्ट नेसेसरी फॉर एनी जर्नी. वी आर ऑल हियर, वी आर ऑल ट्रैवलर्स इन दिस वर्ल्ड, वी आर मेकिंग ए सोजर्न. हम लोग पथिक हैं, संसार विदेश है, हम लोग मुसाफिर है, हम लोग चल रहे हैं. तो कहाँ चल रहे हैं, क्या हमारा लक्ष्य है, वो हमारे मन में उज्ज्वल होना चाहिए. वी शुड नॉट फॉरगेट अवर गोल. श्री रामकृष्णा केम हियर, केम टू दिस वर्ल्ड. गॉड कम्स टू रिमाइंड अस ऑफ अवर गोल. वी हैव फॉरगॉटन, वी आर सिंपली होवरिंग हियर एंड देयर, वैंडरिंग विदाउट एनी पर्पस. देन दैट इज कॉल्ड लक्ष्यहीन. So first we have to identify our goal. Whether we are able to achieve the goal, that is different. But first we should know what is the goal of life. So he has said, Sri Ramakrishna, that the goal of life is to see God. Simple. Ishwar darshan hi manushya jivan ka uddesh hai. Now why manushya jivan? Because it is not possible for other lives. This we must remember. He has not said सब प्राणियों का उद्देश्य ईश्वर लाभ संभव नहीं है. कोई जानवर ईश्वर को दर्शन नहीं कर सकते हैं. तो फॉर सीइंग गॉड वी मस्ट हैव ए ह्यूमन बॉडी. सो दैट मिनिमम रिक्वायरमेंट इज नेसेसरी. विदाउट ए टेलीस्कोप वी कैन नॉट सी द स्टार्स. दैट इंस्ट्रूमेंट इज नेसेसरी. सो द बॉडी ऑफ ए ह्यूमन बीइंग इज नेसेसरी to interact with God. And we are all very fortunate to have this human body. Now the difficulty is, after getting the human body, we feel that something else is necessary. There is our addition, our superstition, our misnomer. Though all human beings are capable to realize God, but the tragedy is hardly anyone believes that he or she can realize God. This is a tragedy of life. ये बड़ा विचित्र है. हर इंसान ईश्वर को दर्शन कर सकते हैं, काबिल है, लेकिन कोई विश्वास नहीं करता है. सब सोचते हैं हमसे नहीं होगा. If you ask anybody, do you think you can realize God? He said no. इज़ नॉट मेंट फॉर मी. हम पापी तापी हैं, हम सर कहाँ किया कर पाएंगे. वो साधु संत उनको लिखे है, हमारे लिए नहीं है, संभव ही नहीं है. नाउ इफ यू आर नॉट कन्विंस्ड अबाउट योर अप्रोचेबिलिटी टू द गोल, यू कैन नेवर रीच देयर. इफ यू थिंक इट इज़ बियॉन्ड योर रीच, देन इट इज़ ओनली अ थियोरिटिकल गोल फॉर यू. बट श्री रामकृष्ण हैज़ नेवर सेट ए थियोरिटिकल गोल. इज़ एन अचीवेबल गोल, फिजिबल गोल. And so then if it is feasible goal and we all are interested to see God, hota kyun nahi? Why are you not able to realize God? This is the topic being discussed today. So here is an interaction between Ishan Chandra Mukherjee and Sri Ramakrishna. This is the topic for discussion. Now who was this Ishan Chandra Mukherjee? He was a great devotee. He was an affluent person. उसका संसार का और कोई कमिटमेंट नहीं था. He has now finished all the commitments of life, an aged person. He has got plenty of resources and he is a devotee of God. Sincerely he is trying. Now he is trying in a ritualistic fashion, as most of us do. We think the religion is a ritual. कोई एक औपचारिकता है, धर्म एक औपचारिकता है. सुबह में इतना समय उठना पड़ेगा, इतना पूजा करना पड़ेगा, इतना भोग चढ़ाना पड़ेगा. दिस इज द वे वी हैव अ लिस्ट टू बी अचीव्ड, टू बी परफॉर्म्ड. वी हैव टू गो इन दिस टेम्पल, वी हैव टू इतना पूजा चढ़ाना है, मंगलवार अच्छा हनुमान मंदिर में विजिट करना है, शनिवार काली मंदिर में जाना है. नाना प्रकार का औपचारिकता है, रिचुअल है. द ईशान ऑल्सो केम टू श्री रामकृष्ण एंड देन ही वॉज डूइंग फॉर्मल वर्शिप, पूजा, सिटिंग इन द नाट मंदिर ऑफ काली टेम्पल. नाउ दिस एनीबडी विल से दिस इज डूइंग ए ग्रेट स्पिरिचुअल एक्टिविटी. कोशाकोशी निये सेखाने पूजा करछेन. नाउ श्री रामकृष्ण इज सेइंग हियर, throw away those articles. You see, now when you are in the company of God, what for you are worshipping God? Why do you worship God? We worship God to invoke His presence. So, ye hai hamara pagalpani. We can never realize that ritual is not the goal of our life. We think that itna kar liya to bahut kar liya. हम इतना जप कर लिया, इतना ध्यान कर लिया, इतना पूजा चढ़ाया, एंड वी फील सेल्फ कॉम्प्लासेंट. सो एवरी मोमेंट वी हैव टू मेक दिस, ये जांच होना चाहिए. हैव यू रियलाइज द गोल? वाज योर गोल टू वर्शिप गॉड और वाज योर गोल टू रियलाइज गॉड? हमें भगवान का पूजा ही हमारा जीवन का लक्ष्य बना लिया. दिस इज वाई वी मिस द मार्क. This is one reason why we miss the mark. He is giving several reasons why we miss the mark. One is our buddhi ka vibhram. Ishan here is he says pagal ho jao, ishwar ke prem mein pagal ho jao. Log agar ye samjhe ki Ishan is samay pagal ho gaya hai, अब यह सब काम नहीं कर सकता है, तो फिर तुम्हारे पास सरपंच बनाने के लिए ना आएंगे. घंटी वंटी उठाकर फेंक दो, अपना ईशान नाम सार्थक करो. ईशान मतलब शिव जी, भगवान शिव के नाम है ईशान. ईश महादेव है, सबसे अच्छा ईश है, भगवान है. ये कहते हैं तुम्हारा नाम सार्थक करो, घंटी वंटी उठा के फेंक दो. स्वयं अच्छा भगवान इज सेइंग नाउ रिचुअल इज नेसेसरी एट द बिगिनिंग, बट वी मस्ट मेक एन एंड. इफ यू स्टे इन प्राइमरी क्लास थ्रू आउट द एंड ऑफ योर लाइफ, वन विल बी प्रोमोटेड टू हाई स्कूल एंड इंटर एंड यूनिवर्सिटी. वी लाइक टू रिमेन इन प्राइमरी क्लास एंड कंटिन्यू टू डू दिस घंटी वंटी सब दिन रात करते रहते हैं, इससे काम नहीं चलेगा. वी मस्ट एलिवेट अवर सेल्फ एंड कॉन्स्टेंट गोल ओरिएंटेशन मस्ट बी देयर. हम कहाँ तक पहुँचना है, हम कहाँ तक पहुँचे हैं, ये चिंतन, ये विचार हर वक्त होना चाहिए. नाउ सो दिस इज वन रीज़न दैट वाई वी डू नॉट मिस, वी डू नॉट गेट टू द गोल. अनदर रीज़न इज दैट वी गेट डिल्यूडेड. वी वॉन्ट टू गो टू द गोल बट बीच में हम फंस जाते हैं. नाना प्रकार का प्रलोभन से हमारा चित्त का विभ्रम होता है. नाउ व्हाट आर दी डिस्ट्रैक्शंस? फोर डिस्ट्रैक्शंस. फर्स्ट इज दैट आवर अट्रैक्शन फॉर सेंसुअल प्लेजर्स, बिकॉज वी हैव गॉट ऑल ह्यूमन बीइंग्स, दो दे हैव द कैपेसिटी टू रियलाइज गॉड. नाउ सो ही हैज सम इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स, ऑल ह्यूमन बींग्स हैज सम इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स, जिसको इंद्रिया कहा जाता है, सेंस ऑर्गन्स, ये यंत्र है. विद दिस दे इंटरैक्ट. नाउ देर आर 11 सेंस ऑर्गन्स. वन इज माइंड विच इज कॉल्ड अंतर इंद्रिय, इंटरनल ऑर्गन, एंड देर आर 10 एक्सटर्नल ऑर्गन्स. Dashendriya, Dashendriyani. So these are now Bahirindriya, external organs. What are they? 5 out of these 10, 5 are Karmendriyani and 5 Gyanendriya. 5 organs of action, 5 organs of knowledge. What are the organs of action? Karmendriya, 5. Vak, Pani, Pada, Pai, Upastha. Speech is an organ by which you interact with the world. Communication, speech. Then hands, with which you work. And then feet, Pada, Vak, Pani, Pada. So these are the Karmendriyas. And 2 lower organs, Pai, Upastha. Now these are the 5 Karmendriyas. And what are the 5 Gyanendriyas? Chokshu Karna Nasika Jiva Tvak. Eyes, ears, nose, tongue, and skin. By eyes we see, by ears we hear, by nose we smell, and by tongue we taste. Now tongue has 2 dual role. That's why tongue is called very important sense organ. It has a dual role. One is, it is used as a speech. So it becomes a karmendriya. And then with this we taste. So that becomes a gyanendriya. And tvach tacha, by which we feel the touch. So these are the 5 gyanendriyas. Now they are unfortunately or directed outside. These all 10 sense organs are directed outside. And the mind is inside. Now, God is seated within our heart. Please see the analysis. Ishvara sarvabhutanam diddeshe arjuna tishtiti. We know that. We hear. Bachpan se hum log sun raha hu, pad raha hu, ji Bhagavan sabke hriday mein virajman hai. Now, kahan hai? Hriday mein hai, bhitar mein hai. So now, in order to see God, we must direct our senses inside. So mind is standing in between the inner world and external world. See, if the mind can be concentrated to the inner world, we can see God. It's very simple. But the mind is being constantly dragged out by these 10 organs. So 1:10. So if the mind is projected outside, then we cannot see God. So now, if like the horns of a mic, they are projected outside. So always the sense organs are projected outside, and there are all these sense objects around it. Now, as an iron filing has a natural attraction to a magnet, so the sense organs and sense objects are mutually attracted. It's a very natural thing. If you put an iron filing and a magnet, iron filing naturally go to the magnet. So if you put a sight and put your eyes will automatically go to the sight. So this external world is full of these sense objects are constantly attracting our sense organs. And thereby the mind is dragged to the external world. Now who has directed? God has created us. He is sitting within and has given us these wonderful instruments to see Him. How do I see God? I see with my eyes. But if the eyes are projected away from God, how can I see? Now who has designed this projection? God Himself. That is the secret of creation. God has created us. And God wants that we should see Him, but He has made such a labyrinth that instead of seeing Him, we see the outside world and we miss the mark. So He is giving the state of the art that why we cannot see God. At the same time, He is giving the solution also. That's why He has come. He's not only saying that why we get befooled, but He is saying that what is the way out. Is told in the Upanishads, as I ended in the last Sunday class, This has been nicely mentioned in the Upanishad, in the Kathopanishad. Paranchikhari vatina sambhu tasmat parang pashyati na antaratman. This Sayambhu, God is there. Now God becomes man. When he takes a human being form, he looks as if the same as the human being. Bhagavan jab nararoop se aate hain, ekdam insaan ke tarah unko behave hota hai. Now what is the difference between human being and God in human form? Bhagavan ek Krishna roop dharan kar liya, Ram roop dharan kar liya, Ram Krishna roop dharan kar liya. जब उधर सामने आते हैं बराबर एकदम, उसका भी भूख प्यास है, सब इंसान का भूख प्यास है, वो भी सोते हैं ये भी सोते हैं. फ़र्क क्या है? फ़र्क है कि ही डज नॉट गेट डिल्यूडेड बाई दिस माया एंड वी गेट डिल्यूडेड. तो ईश्वर को कहा जाता है मायाधीश एंड जीव इज मायाधीन. जस्ट वन लेटर का फ़र्क है, वन अक्षर का फ़र्क है. ईश्वर इज मायाधीश, ही इज अबव द माया, दिस डिल्यूशन. ही डजंट, ये अच्छा ये नहीं फंसता, दिमाग बहुत साफ है भगवान का, वो कभी फंसेगा नहीं. लेकिन इंसान क्या है? मायाधीन है, हम फंस जाते हैं. और ये जो उनका जो माया है, जो चातुरी है, मैजिक है, डिल्यूशन है, इतना पावरफुल है कि हम उनसे फंस जाते हैं. तो भगवान भी तो इस दुनिया में रहते हैं, इस माया पर रहते हैं, उनका आंखें भी तो बाहर में प्रोजेक्टेड है. तो हाउ डज इट नॉट गेट बिल्यूडेड? बिकॉज ही हैज़ दैट कैपेसिटी. श्री रामकृष्ण गिव्स द एग्जाम्पल, जो सांप का मुंह में जहर रहता है, द पॉइजन रिमेंस इन द माउथ ऑफ द स्नेक बट इट डज नॉट डू एनी हार्म. कोई सांप का जहर से कोई नुकसान नहीं होगा, लेकिन दूसरा को काटेगा मर जाएगा. तो इसीलिए भगवान का जो ये डिल्यूशन है, उससे भगवान का कोई फर्क नहीं आता. इसीलिए इसको कहा जाता है स्वयंभू, इज मास्टर्ड हिमसेल्फ. वी आर नॉट स्वयंभू, वी आर अंडर माया, अंडर डिल्यूशन. भगवान इज मायाधीश, इट इज हिज माया, ही हैज द कंट्रोलर. ए मैजिशियन इज नॉट डिल्यूडेड बाई हिज मैजिक बिकॉज इट इज हिज क्रिएशन. The audience will be deluded. भगवान वैसे magician है, एक उनको चातुरी है, वो magic भोजबाजी दिखाते हैं. To magician, he is not covered by the magic because it is his magic. He knows what he is doing. इसीलिए उपनिषद ने बताई वो स्वयंभू है. तो what is the design? खानी, खानी means इंद्रियानी, परांची, our इंद्रियाज are projected outside. परंग आउटसाइड, परांची खानी बैतरीनाथ स्वयंभू. स्वयंभू जो है भगवान, बदमाशी करके ऐसे बंदोबस्त किया है. बैतरीनाथ हिंसत, भगवान हिंसा करके किया है. ऐसे बच्चे ऐसे ऋषि कहते हैं, भगवान नहीं चाहते हम उसको प्राप्त करें. बैतरीनाथ स्वयंभू हमसे वो नहीं चाहते हम उसको प्राप्त करें. देन व्हाट हैज डन? तस्मात परांग पश्यति नांतरात्मन, आपने को छिपा लिया. दुनिया में सर्वत्र विराजमान है, ही इज प्रेजेंट एवरीवेयर बट ही इज कवर्ड हिमसेल्फ. ही ये भीतर में है एंड वी आर ऑल सीइंग आउटसाइड. तो देन व्हाट इज द वे आउट? कश्चित धीरः बट देर आर सर्टेन वाइज पीपल, कोई बुद्धिमान व्यक्ति है, धीर व्यक्ति है. प्रत्येक आत्मान मैक्षत in order to see God, because that is the goal of life. Those who are sincerely wishing, willing to see God, there is a way out. What is that way out? Bodhisattva karte hain kaschid dhirah pratyak atmanam ikshat abrit chakshur amritatvam icchan. Agar amrit ko paane chahte ho to chakshu band karo, arthat direct your sense organs inside. बस इतना ही. द सेंस ऑर्गन्स विच आर प्रोजेक्टेड आउटसाइड कॉन्स्टेंटली बिजी इन सीइंग द वर्ल्ड, वॉट एवर सी यू आर, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू आर बिजी विथ योर एक्टिविटीज, देन यू गेट कॉन्स्टेंटली अट्रैक्टेड टुवर्ड्स योर सेंस ऑर्गन्स. सो दैट्स वाई स्वामी श्री रामकृष्ण सेज द फोर ऑब्स्ट्रैक्शंस, फोर डिस्ट्रैक्शंस. फर्स्ट इज अट्रैक्शन फॉर द सेंस प्लेजर्स, attraction of the natural attraction of sense organs to sense objects, जिसको काम कहा जाता है, पैशन कहा जाता है, कामिनी का नाम भी उत्तर किया है. कामिनी डज नॉट मीन वीमेन, कामिनी सिग्निफाइज अवर पैशन, दी इंद्रिया का, इंद्रिया वस्तु के प्रति आकर्षण, स्वाभाविक आकर्षण. नाउ देन देर इज वेल्थ, कांचन. देर इज नथिंग इन द वेल्थ, दिस वेल्थ द रुपया है जो हमारे धन है. नाउ द वेल्थ डज नॉट हैव एनी वैल्यू ऑन इट्स ओन. वेल्थ हेल्प्स अस टू एंजॉय अवर लाइफ, वेल्थ हेल्प्स अस फॉर योर सेंस प्लेजर्स, नॉट नेसेसरीली. वेल्थ इज नॉट ओनली, वेल्थ नॉट ओनली एनेबल्स यू टू एंजॉय योर सेंस ऑर्गन्स, वेल्थ हैज अनदर डायमेंशन. Wealth has an attraction of its own that has to be understood. Because dhan se kya hota hai? Rupiya se kuch matlab nahi hai. The notes does not have any value of itself. Notes does not have any value. Jala dijiye kuch nahi milega. Lekin jo bank notes pe kya hoga? Aap kuch khareed sakte ho. Whatever you want, you can enjoy your life through that money. But wealth has another dimension that we have to understand. That is, it is having a natural attraction. Think of a miser, जो कृपण है वो धन इस्तेमाल नहीं करते हैं, लेकिन सुबह में उठकर जो पासबुक देखते हुए बहुत आनंद होता है कि कल मेरा 50,000 था, आज 55 हुआ. But that money he is not going to use in his life, someone else will use. But that gives a very very pleasure, and उसके वजह से वो जीवन बर्बाद कर देते हैं. So Sri Ramakrishna says, beware of this attraction for wealth. So this is the second attraction, because your goal is not to acquire wealth. Your goal is to not increase your bank balance and leave it for someone else, neither to enjoy for yourself. Your goal is to realize God, to orient your life. These two things ho gaya. So now most of the people who are intelligent, they have somehow been able to this get settled with their individual life and also their management of the wealth. But then there are two more obstructions. Naam Josh. Kamini, Kanchan, Naam Josh. Lust, wealth, name, fame. Now, first is that you want to be propagated. Now, so this name is attached to this physical body. Whose name is there? Name is the physical body. So the name and fame also, this physical person. This attachment to this physical body and to make it perpetually eternal, there is another peculiar aspect of life. Now all of us want to live forever, not bad, that is our internal nature. We want to be happy, we want to exist, we want to know. Now we know that this body has a physical longevity. After some time this body will die. What we aspire, let this body die, but then jo hamara naam hai wo barabar reh jaye. कीर्ति जैसे सजीवती, वी वॉन्ट टू मेक सम कीर्ति, सम कुछ करने चाहते हैं जबकि हमारा नाम बराबर रह जाए. सो दिस एग्जिस्टेंस बाय परपिचुएटिंग अवर नेम एंड वी स्पेंड ऑल अवर एनर्जी. नाउ वी टू गेट ए पॉज एंड थिंक. नाउ देयर हैव बीन सो मेनी पीपल हु वेर वेरी रिनाउंड, हु वेर रिमेंबर्ड ड्यूरिंग देयर लाइफ टाइम एंड हु वेर रिमेंबर्ड इवन आफ्टर देयर लाइफ टाइम. But how many still remains in the work of history? In the annals of history, histories are made and histories are obliterated. And fame that people praise, see, this is another, is our ego. People make him a lot of praise. He has finished all his duties of life. Now this is the category Ishan falls in here. He has no so much attraction for money. he has no so much attraction for his physical enjoyment, and is not after making a name and fame, making a research, writing papers after papers, so that more papers come, his name is more emblazoned, and he is nominated for Padma Shri, Padma Vibhushan, nana prakar ka usko anad ye wo uska reward mile, naam bada ho jaye, agban mein uska naam nikle. This is one thing, and this jash is people, then he becomes a popularity. Another direction is popularity. He has done everything, now abhi neta ban gaya, koi rajniti mein naam likhaya, Rotary Club mein naam likhaya, and then he becomes a counselor. Then when he becomes a very, very recognized person, people come to him. People come to him and go on praising. We are very much infatuated with praise. अगर कोई आदमी आके बताएं आप जैसा आदमी नहीं हुआ बस द गोल ओरिएंटेशन शुड बी दीज आर द डिस्ट्रैक्शंस दीज आर द डिस्ट्रैक्शन आई ऑलवेज नोट दिस पिक्यूलियर थिंग नाउडेज यू हैव दिस इलेक्ट्रॉनिक गैजेट्स नाउ व्हाट एवर टाइम इट रिमेन्स पीपल यूज दिस इलेक्ट्रॉनिक गैजेट फॉर एलिवेटिंग फॉर देयर स्पिरिचुअल अपलिफ्टमेंट नाउ यू नो सी देयर इज ए सिस्टम ऑफ व्हाट्सएप व्हाट्सएप में बहुत अच्छा अच्छा मैसेज आता है इफ़ यू स्टडी इफ़ यू रीड तो उसमें यू गेट सम एलिवेशन स्पिरिचुअल एलिवेटेड नो ए पिक्यूलर ट्रेंड हैज कम ए गुड मैसेज कम्स यू रीड इट एंड देन ए नोटिस कम प्लीज फॉरवर्ड इट टू 10 persons व्हाई बिकॉज दे विल प्रेज यू अरे आप तो बहुत अच्छा सुनाया नाउ यू गेट ए मैसेज योर टाइम इज वेस्टेड in forwarding these people everywhere, but that has not gone inside. You don't learn from yourself. So you become a carrier of message, carrier of thoughts, and without trying to make it for our own. Shobare shikhai koto niti kotha, nijere shudhu shikhai na. That is not meant for us. That is meant to hear and then communicate. We become the mechanism of downloading and uploading information in whatever form. That is not spirituality. We have to be very alert. Our time is very limited. We are not here forever. Whatever time is remaining, that should be utilized to our goal orientation, realize God. And these distractions are so powerful that we cannot get rid of it. You think very deeply, because these distractions are created by God Himself. In Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavan says, "Daivi hi esha gunamayi mama maya durattaya." This daivi maya, this is not creation of a satan. कोई satan create नहीं किया, स्वयं भगवान का सृजन है. This delusion, this maya. And what is the nature? Trigunatmika, gunamayi. What is this guna? Sattva, rajaha, tamaha. And that is the composition of our own mind. Our mind is composed of 3 constituents. Sattva, rajaha, tamaha. Poise, dynamism, inertia. So the composition of the mind is created by God Himself, which is a thing of delusion. So we are always under the spell of delusion. And he adds, durottaya, durotikramma. It is almost impossible to get rid of this maya. So that is the question he has said. Now, Ishan is asking that what is the way out? Sri Ramakrishna gives the example of Keshav Chandra Sen. I already discussed in our last couple of classes, Keshav Chandra Sen was an ideal example, great orator, great accomplished person. He was a mover of the Brahma Samaj. He was called by the queen. Now, Sri Ramakrishna says, Keshav himself is saying, why am I not able to realize God? What a tragedy. Agar Keshav Sen jaise aadmi ka Bhagavan laam nahi hota, kisko hoga? When God realization is possible for every human being, why is it not for such an exalted soul like Keshav Chandra Sen? Because he says, you are busy in counseling others. You are not interested for your own personal realization. Here, taking another example of Shambhu Mallik. Now, Shambhu Mallik was a great person. He was a great benefactor. He was making lot of charitable activities, dispensaries, schools, hospitals, roads. Now Sri Ramakrishna says that when God comes to you, what will you do? Will you tell him to make more charitable hospitals and schools, or else you want to see him? So there is a very important dichotomy we have to make, that what is the goal of life and how to reach it. So here Keshav Chandra Sen has said, and also Ishan Chandra is telling, that concentrate all your attention for the realization of God and God alone. First, we must, our philosophy should be clear. It is said, for the beginners, those who are starting, we have to get involved in some voluntary charitable activities, Jagat Hita. That's why the motto set forth by Swami Vivekananda has to be properly understood. Atmano mokshartham jagat hitaya cha. He has not said Atmana mokshartaya jagat hita. We have to do good to the world for self-emancipation. That is not. He said cha is and. It is a dual role of life. We must try to realize God by self-introspection and also to good to the world, to keep the mind clear. Both has to be done hand in hand. Not one after the other, or not one leads to other. These two have to be completely, continuously augmented in our life. In this matter, when we do, we find the mind is become so much distracted, it is almost impossible. Hota nahi. So then Bhagavan is giving the clue that this is mama maya durattaya. Then what is the way out? In the next half of the verse, he says, Mamiva japrabadyante maya metam tadantite. This maya you can get rid only by taking refuge to me and no other, because it is created by him. You cannot challenge God. You are not more powerful. You try what may. But this attempt should be done. ये पढ़ने से नहीं होगा, आप कोशिश करके देखो, जब हार जाओगे तब भगवान का चरण में आ जाओ, शरण में आ जाओ. तो जितना जल्दी आ जाओ उतना अच्छा है. तो देन ही गिव्स अ क्लू, दिस इज द वे आउट. इफ यू टेक रिफ्यूज इन द फीट ऑफ गॉड, देन ही मेक्स अस इजी, वो खोल देंगे रास्ता. दैट्स व्हाई स्वामी विवेकानंद हैज टॉट अस, तस्मात तम एव शरण. तस्मात मतलब व्हाई, therefore matlab I tried and I failed, therefore. So karke dekhna chahiye, hoga nahi. Tasma, that's why. Tam eva sharanam, thou alone is my refuge. Mama dina bandhu, wo din bandhu hai, lekin jisko sharan lete usi ke baad karega, nahi to nahi. Ghamand se jane se nahi hoga. Now when we take refuge in God, so there are two way outs to get rid of this riddle. One is if you analyze. When you analyze, then you find that this world is a labyrinth, you can go out. So viveka. So vivek, if you apply your discrimination, then there is a natural dispassion. Vairagya ho jayega, distaste ho jayega. By that you can get rid. But though everyone has this power of discrimination within us, it is hidden, it is not used, it is sheathed. Is koshabaddha hai, is sheathed, it is covered, discrimination. So how can we uncover our vivek? We have this power of discrimination, but how can we energize it, make it active? By taking refuge in God. And Bhagavan gives this clue in the Bhagavad Gita. तेषां सतत युक्तानां भजतां प्रीतिपूर्वकं ददामि बुद्धि योगं तं येन माम उपजान्ति ते. इफ वन कम्स टू मी विद भक्ति, देन आई गिव हिम दैट बुद्धि, दैट इंटेलिजेंस बाय विच ही कैन गेट रीड ऑफ दिस डिल्यूशन. सो अल्टीमेट गो इज द विवेक, बट विवेक इज निद्रित है, स्लीपिंग. आवर डिस्क्रिमिनेशन इज स्लीपिंग, दैट हैज टू बी मेड जागरित. We have to awaken our power of discrimination, that can be done by taking refuge in the feet of God. That is the dictate Sri Ramakrishna is telling us, that this world is full of delusion. Remember your goal, that is God realization. You can have it, but you will steer clear with this power of discrimination generated by your devotion to God. We'll continue further in our next Sunday class. In the next Sunday, there will be initiation, so we'll meet again in the month of March.
Niranjanam nityam anantarupam bhaktanukampadhritavikraham vai Ishavataram parameshamidyam tam Ramakrishnam shirasanamama Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Tat Sat Shri Ramakrishnarpanamastu.
This announcement, tomorrow is the birth anniversary of Swami Adbhutananda Ji Maharaj, one of the direct sannyasi disciples of Sri Ramakrishna. And tomorrow is also Purnima, full moon day, so we'll have his life and discourses by Swami Nirvikalpananda Ji Maharaj and followed by Shyamnam Sankirtan. And Revered Swami Gautamananda Ji Maharaj is arriving tomorrow morning. So he'll be present tomorrow and we can have his darshan pranam. He'll be leaving on 29th of February. In the meantime, 27th and 28th, he'll have mantra diksha. And 28th, that is next Sunday evening, he'll give a talk, Adhyatmik Jivan Ke Patha Nirdesh, the guidelines of spiritual life. We close now with the chanting of the Lord. Please join with me. Hari Om Ram Krishna, Hari Om Ram Krishna, Hari Om Ram Krishna, Hari Om. Hari Om Ram Krishna, Hari Om Ram Krishna, Hari Om Ram Krishna, Hari Om. Hari Om Ram Krishna, Hari